even though the disbelievers, they hate it, they detest it. Even if they smile in our faces and don't say it, they hate it and they detest it because it's a threat to the life that they want to live and the law they want to establish and the life that they want to establish throughout the earth, whether it is called today globalism, imperialism, or communism, or socialism, or capitalism, or hisism, or sheism. The Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, told us that the deen of Islam began as a stranger, yes. When Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, came, he was known to his people. His character was known. His person was known. His family, his tribe was known. So what did it mean that Islam started as a stranger? The Arabs, they knew his language. When he told them what he heard from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they didn't understand it because the context of it was divine. Had it been just mundane, something from themselves, they would have understood it and appreciated it. But they understood it was something divine, something unique. So it was strange what he was calling them to. It was strange the characteristics he had adopted, the values, the principles, the behaviors, the etiquettes. And then those who came to him, they wanted to imitate him. So they also became strange, and they became estranged even to their mothers and fathers and sisters and brothers. They became estranged. So we see today, there's a distinction with Muslims wheresoever they are. By the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I have visited more than 37 countries, or at least 37 countries. And one of the strange things that I have found is that when you go to a country and you find Muslims in that same country, let's take China for instance. You take Chinese Muslims. They are very distinct from the other Chinese. The other Chinese, they eat everything. Dogs, cats, and they got some Chinese that when their relatives die, they don't bury them. They cook them and eat them. So you have some Chinese who have no rules. They are filthy people, absolutely filthy people, even to the degree that in most of China, when someone becomes 65 or 70 years old, they're of no use anymore. They put them to sleep. This is the kind of people they are, because they are godless and heedless people. On the other hand, you have 180 million Chinese in China who have a love for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you find them emanating the same behavior. Love for the elderly, love for the youth. You see them cutting their fingernails and trimming themselves and loving the perfume and wearing clean clothing and praying five times a day and making ghusl and having the good manners of the Quran and the Sunnah. What's the difference? The difference is the acculturation of the Quran and the Sunnah. This is the same in every country you will find. You will even find this difference within a family. A family. A Muslim in the family, a kafir in a family. You'll find the difference right there. Why? Because Islam began as a stranger.